So we've got Paul Joseph Wetlips Watson being the normal piece of shit that he is. Let's watch, shall we?
This is a space where we can recognize that we're angry.
Now see, if he had any sort of journalistic integrity or professional integrity, this would not be the response. But the goal is to make fun of people. That's what he's doing. Just continue to watch.
We want to destroy the conservative government. We want to bring down the patriarchy.
So the first rule of Feminist Fight Club is... talk about Feminist Fight Club.
I mean, isn't it awful how all these bigots stereotype feminists as being fat, angry, ugly misfits?
God only knows where they get that idea from.
That's the old stereotype, based off of before, like, fourth wave feminism that has really messed up the name of feminism. And you're going to poke fun at it, too. I understand that you have this agenda, but it's...
before the fight, I always think about how angry I am. I think about the man that catcalled me on the street.
I'm sure you get catcalled all the time, love.
If you don't understand what they're doing or can't see what they're doing, it's time to make fun of appearances.
My name is Phoebe Patey Ferguson, and I founded Femme Feral. We fight each other as a mode of resistance to try and channel our energies and our rage.
Sounds constructive to me. It may not be considered normal. But it sure seems constructive, but, you know, we can't possibly look at it as constructive.
So you've got a triple-barreled name and you go to a prestigious London university. Yeah, you don't sound very oppressed to me.
Actual oppression levels don't really matter. You know, the actual oppression levels of some of these kids who go on shooting sprees, yeah, their oppression level isn't as much of a concern as the systems we have in place, the kinds of peer pressure that you find all over the place, the standards we put on ourselves. Some of these things are oppressive to everyone. And if it affects one group slightly differently than another, if they find some way that's constructive to deal with it, what's it to you to sit there and make fun of it? Well, I guess that's your way of dealing with your problems, is to make fun of everyone else, right?
You sound like another privileged, entitled, inherited wealth snowflake.
Whether they are or they aren't, what they're doing isn't hurting anything. It's their own event, you're not paying for it. And they're trying to vent their anger in ways that aren't going to be harmful to anyone. But you have to make fun of that because you're an asshole.
Let me do a little mansplaining about real feminism. Real feminism is...
let me guess. Everything that's happening in other countries and nothing that's happening in first world industrialized nations. So that means there's nothing left to do here, not even anything about social attitudes or anything. There's nothing left to do here at all.
Risking arrest and torture for removing your hijab in public. Real feminism is marching in the streets against a theocratic tyranny. Real feminism is strapping on a machine gun to kick some ISIS ass.
Fighting a war in the military is not feminism. It's people doing courageous things. But it's not feminism.
You rolling around in a basement in your sweaty underpants while screaming incoherently, that's not real feminism.
It's things that some feminists are doing, but to say that that's actually feminism, that is feminism? Well, no. And I don't think they're saying that either. So, you know, banana.
When you feel, like, empowered by the numbers, actually, like, yeah, it feels like you can go out and... smash some shit or something.
Now, like, forgive me for being, like, frank, but, like, the only thing you should be smashing is the Weight Watchers weekly meal plan.
Irrelevant. But the alt-light, alt-right types would consider that an argument somehow. You know, winning. Let me ask you something that you'll never see because I'm just a nobody on this platform, but have you ever been to any non-standard, weird event where people get together and have a good time and vent their frustrations and do anything like that? Have you had anything like that whatsoever? And if you haven't, then who the hell are you to judge any of this?
I have experienced moments of a lot of suppression and repression. Or not moments, but a lifetime of that, actually.
That they have been oppressed and are very oppressed.
Really? A lifetime of oppression? You? Really?
Who are you to judge how someone has been oppressed? What do you know about that person? What, because they look a certain way? Well, if someone has an unusual look, they must not be oppressed at all. How do you know what some... Maybe the way that they look is to battle things that they went through in the earlier part of their life. Who the hell are you to judge this sort of thing? I could try to judge you and how much you've been oppressed and what you've went through based off of your looks, and I'd probably be wrong.
You, with your plummy accent and your leisure time spent painting your face while rolling around in a cellar in some upper-middle-class hipster enclave, let me do a little mansplaining about real oppression.
Something, something, Islam, something, in 3, 2, 1.
Real oppression is having your genitals mutilated to fulfill the dictates of a backwards belief system. Real oppression is being subjected to constant death threats for trying to renounce a religion that kills people who try to leave it.
Look, I get it, and most people get it, okay? Islam, as it is practiced across the globe, is a shitty thing. It needs reformation the same way that Christianity, for the most part across the globe, has been reformed. Now, there's a few places where Christianity has not been reformed very well yet, and you've got a lot of the same shit going on in some of those countries. There are some countries in Africa that contain some of this shit. But for the most part, Christianity has been reformed. Islam needs some of that going on, but it's taking a lot longer. Okay, so I'm not going to claim that Islam is some wonderful thing.
And overcoming all this to escape a ghetto in Somalia to become one of the most influential women on the planet. That's real oppression. You being triggered by a Sargon of Akkad video, that's not real oppression.
Where did you get the impression that they're having these gatherings because of Sargon of Akkad videos?
It's difficult to be sexy in specific spaces without being sexualized.
Yeah, preventing it from becoming sexualized may have been made more difficult by the fact that someone's drawn a giant cock on the wall.
So because they have a drawing on the wall, that means that they can't do something that has to do with nudity without it being sexualized. All you know are your traditionalist views. Anything going outside of it is so uncomfortable that it makes you laugh out of nervousness or makes you want to stomp on it because it makes you uncomfortable.
Fuck you, Theresa May! Fuck you, Theresa May!
Now, I'm no fan of Theresa May, but if she wants to get re-elected, this shit should be going in her campaign ad.
Fuck you, Theresa May!
So you want to fight the patriarchy by removing Britain's first female prime minister in 2 decades and replacing her with a man from a party that in its entire history of existence has never had a female leader.
So now it's about the gender and not the ideas? Why don't you make up your mind?
A party that organises political meetings where women are segregated to appease an actual patriarchal belief system.
And this is the only good point that you make in your video.
That's how you're gonna bring down the patriarchy. Somewhere in there we hear a muddled argument about drawing attention to domestic violence. Even though every study shows that lesbians are statistically far more likely to be violent than heterosexual couples.
So now in a movement that you think is already focusing on things that aren't really that important, they should focus on a small minority of the women that are affected when it comes to domestic abuse. Alrighty, dude.
Not that I'm saying any of them are lesbians.
Yeah, not that you have a problem with that or anything. Oh, you like it when it's sex tapes, right?
I mean, is it any wonder that just 7%, 7% of people in the UK identify as feminists?
You're right. Fewer people are identifying as feminists. Because there are some crazies out there, well, this is one of the reasons, because there are some crazies out there ruining it for the movement.
When even members of Vice's hardcore audience is saying it's cringy, chances are it's cringy. How do you think the vast majority of young women are going to react when they watch this?
It's not for everyone, so what?
If you really want to bring down the patriarchy, why aren't you encouraging women to get STEM degrees?
That's probably good advice.
If you really want to end the oppression of women, why don't you draw attention to countries in the world where women are actually being oppressed?
Tell me, sir, what are we going to do about it? What are we supposed to do about it? Are we going to end their religion? What are we going to do about it in those countries? We have no power over them.
Theresa May and the Tories aren't stoning women to death for violating Sharia law. Theresa May and the Tories aren't passing laws that legalize marital rape. Theresa May and the Tories aren't instructing police to round up women if their headscarf slips.
She broke Islamic dress code.
We live in a world where grid girls are being eliminated. And this is what the media chooses to promote instead.
One video that you didn't like.
This is why aliens won't talk to us. Listen, I know this is probably the greatest amount of calories you've burned since you had that mental breakdown 2 years ago over that Milo speech.
Feminism is cancer. Thank you very much.
And for that, you should be applauded. But seriously, put your clothes back on.
Why should they?
Wash the clown makeup off and sign up for a gym membership. You're not going to overthrow the government. You're only going to embarrass yourselves.
Oh, well, they're not hurting anything. And at least they're venting their frustrations in ways that are not damaging to anyone.